survey says it's 6 o'clock, time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Denyer.
Two Aussie families stand ready to battle it out, guessing the answers to some simple questions. And the winner gets a chance to play for $10,000 and maybe even a brand new Mitsubishi Outlander SUV. Not a bad start to the weekend. Let's meet our families. First up, our carryover champs here for their fourth night in a row. It's the Garcarczyk family. Welcome back, man. You guys are red hot and on a roll right now.
We've been a bit lucky, I think.
Oh, I don't think so at all. It's all skill so far. So just remind us who's on board your winning team.
We've got my beautiful daughter, Jasmine, and her equally beautiful sister, or my other daughter, Jade, and her beautiful partner, Baby.
Delicious. I'd say delicious. And ready to take them on tonight, it's here for the Pointer family.
Beautiful.
How you going?
Not one to preference. Welcome along.
Thank you.
Please introduce us.
This is my wife, Kylie, my oldest daughter, Hayley, and my mum, Jacqueline.
Great to have you guys here. We all ready for some Friday fun? Let's play the Feud, team captains. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name a type of coach. Craig.
Football.
Football coach. Top answer. Hi, Kylie.
How are you, Grant?
Lovely to see you.
Likewise.
You're looking a little sheepish behind the podium
there. I am a
little
bit. A bit nerve-wracking.
Are you?
Yeah, just a little.
What could be possibly intimidating about this experience?
You.
Is it all this 19 foot of me that stands here in front of you? Is it my size that you
it
find
is.
Intimidating?
It is.
I hear that a lot. Name a type of coach.
Basketball.
Basketball coach. Believe it or not, Kylie, had one of those as a kid as well. Just obviously never took off. Hi, Hayley, how are you?
Good, thank you.
A type of coach.
Soccer.
Soccer coach. Good. Jackie, lovely to have you.
Thank you.
Do you read tarot cards?
Yes.
Really? Yeah. You know what is a little intimidating is the fact that when you look at me, I think you're reading my mind.
I did last night when you were doing this.
Did you? Oh, my God. Was there anything in there?
Yeah.
Tonight should be very easy for you, Jackie.
No, it won't.
Name a type of coach.
A swimming coach.
Swimming coach is lovely. Nice work. Righto, Craig.
Okay.
Type of coach, my friend.
Rugby.
Rugby coach. Nice. Oh. First strike, I'm afraid. Kylie?
I'd say singing.
A singing coach. Lovely. Second strike. The Garcarczyk family couldn't steal. Hayley, name a type of coach.
I would probably go with a hockey.
Hockey coach? Let's see if it's on the board. No, it's not. Okay, three strikes, so it's over the Garcarczyks. Baden.
A life coach.
Life coach is pretty deep. I like it. Jade.
I'm a tennis player, so I'm going to go tennis coach.
Tennis coach, cool. Jasmine.
Tennis coach.
Tennis coach too. Fred.
They're all great tennis players, so I'll have to say tennis coach.
Tennis coach it is for the steal. Let's see if it gets you some points. No, it doesn't. So the Pointers are in the game, grabbing that first bag of points. Remaining answers are 8. Baden. 7. It's 0-64 right now, and if they go on to win for 5 nights in a row, these guys aren't that far away from it either. They could be taking home the amazing all-new Mitsubishi Outlander. Now, the Outlander seats 5 with features including Mitsubishi's multi-communication system, dusk-sensing headlamps and CVT auto with paddle shift. Now, here's a question for everybody playing along at home. I want the top answer to this one. Name something you see stuck to a refrigerator. Let's compare answers when we all come back on this fantastic Friday on Family Feud. Don't go anywhere. Competing for the chance to win $10,000. Now, the Garcarczyk family are 0 at the moment. The Pointers have it. The newbies are there with 64 to get us started. Now, before the break, I asked, name something you see stuck to a refrigerator. The top answer was Madness! Nice work, everybody. Jasmine, Kylie, let's play the Feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something you do to try and entertain a toddler. Jasmine.
Drawings?
You draw.
With them?
No, afraid not. Kylie.
Read a book.
Read a book is not bad. Pass or play? Something you do to try and entertain a toddler?
Play a game.
Just play games with them. I love that. Good. Name something you do to try and entertain a toddler.
I'd take them to the park.
Let's see. First strike. Craig.
Sing.
You good singer?
No, no good.
So, like, what would you sing then?
Mary Had a Little Lamb.
Oh, I bet you they were entertained.
They were, definitely.
What about singing? Good job. Kylie.
Just toys in general.
You just throw a couple of toys in front of them. Not at them, in front of them. What about toys? Good. Name something you do to try and entertain a toddler.
Let them watch TV.
Let them watch TV. Just whack the box on and go, hey, Family Feud's on. The world's most awesome show. Check it out, toddler. Jackie, name something you do to try and entertain a toddler.
I teach them to paint.
Yeah, nice. Yeah. My daughter loves that. Second strike. Okay, guys, get ready for a steal, potentially. Craig, you can stop him. Name something you do to try and entertain a toddler.
Pull faces.
Such as? Pull faces. Good job. Nice work, Kylie. Keep the good times going.
Okay, feed them.
You feed them? That's not bad. Three strikes, I'm afraid. All right, Maiden.
Make funny noises?
Don't you do that to me ever again. Jade.
Laugh at them.
Cool.
Them.
Jasmine.
Dance with them?
You just dance with them. Yeah, cool. Fred, some really cool options.
Oh, gosh. I've got one of my own in my mind, but...
Hey, well, if it's a good one, maybe it's a winning one.
I'm going to go with Baden's, seeing as he had the right one last time.
What did you say?
Noises, Fred.
Oh, noises. Mm. In that case, I'll go... dance with them.
You want to go with dance with them?
Dance with them
for the steal. Oh! The guitar checks jumped to 73 and jumped to the lead. Last answer on the board was... Well, there you have it, 73 to 64. She's a close one. Double points on this fabulous Friday. Give me Jade, give me Hayley. Let's play. We surveyed 100 people and the top 5 answers are on the board. Name something that has a border. Anybody, someone. Hayley.
A maze.
A maze has a border. No, it doesn't. Jade.
A frame?
A frame might have a border. Pass or play?
Pass.
You guys are going to play. I'm sensing this is a tricky one. Mm. Tell me about your friend's strawberry patch.
She always wanted to make big money and she heard that if she bought these new strawberry plants that came out in Coffs Harbour, they were bigger, redder, juicier and grew fast. So she put in 500 plants and she went on and on about these strawberries and how much money she'd make. So I went to Woolgoolga and I bought every punnet of strawberries I could get, brought them back and stuck them all over the strawberries. And she came home and we knew at 5 o'clock she'd go out and water them. Anyway, her father-in-law got to it first and he said, Pauline, Pauline, quick, the strawberries are everywhere. And she ran up the yard, because we were all on our hands and knees at her daughter's bedroom window watching, and she said, Pop, go in and order another 1,000 or whatever
it was. They've grown overnight.
She took the hose off him and she squirted a whole bunch of them together and they all rolled off the plants and she turned around at the house and she's gone, you bitch, Jackie. She knew I'd done it.
What a trick.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm glad I asked that question. That was, that was a long story, but a beautiful story. That was good. Name something that has a border.
A photograph.
Photograph, I love that. Good, great job, Jackie. Great.
I'm going to say state.
Yeah. Ooh, the state border. State. Good thinking. Nice work. Kylie.
I'm going to say your homework in general. You've got to do a border.
A border around your homework.
Yeah,
yeah, like sort of creative. Of that. I see where you're going. I see where you're going.
Yeah.
No. Birds strike, I'm afraid. Hayley?
Your house. It's a border.
There's a border, it. A border around
You've
your house.
You've got a border for your land.
Yeah, so, fence.
Yeah.
Fence is a border.
Yeah.
Your house is a border. Second strike. Get ready to steal. Garcarczyk's.
Jackie. A newspaper.
Newspaper has a border. Let's see if you're right. Good try. Sorry, guys. Baden.
Country.
Country. Lovely. Jade.
Garden bed.
Garden bed, mate. Jasmine.
Poster.
Poster's got a border. Fred.
Without a doubt, country.
Country border.
Would be the top answer, I'm sure.
Ooh, let's see if you're right. Oh, man! Cool, calm, confident, more importantly, correct. Number five. Or a page might have a border, which is kind of what where people were sort of going. Well played, though. Garcarczyk's 265 to 64. And we've got a red hot show tonight. Now, we know you like watching Family Feud, then why not play along at home with the official Family Feud game? Simply head to 10play and look for Family Feud, and you'll also see the highlights and the fun stuff that goes on behind the scenes as well. It's a little special treat or two for you there. It's triple points time. Don't give up, team. We can do this. When we come back, let's find out if they can right here in Family Feud. Welcome back to Point of Family on 64. The Garcarczyk's have it at the moment, 265. They lead the competition. It's the family gets the 300 points. And this round could win the $10,000, potentially. And pointers, triple points right now, OK? So cool news. Give me Baden. Give me Jackie. Let's play. We surveyed 100 people and the top seven answers are on the board. Name something a man might do all day long if his partner let him. Baden.
Sit on the couch.
Sit on the couch just all day. Oh. Jackie.
Watch football.
Watch the footy. Yeah. That's okay, Jackie. That's okay. Play. Been guilty of it?
Yes, many times.
Name something a man might do all day long if his partner let him.
Nothing.
Nothing is your answer.
Nothing.
I just do nothing. Nope. What about nothing? Oh, I thought that was a great answer. Kylie.
I'd say drink alcohol.
Drink alcohol might be a potential option.
Mm.
Good job. Hayley.
I would say sleep.
Just sleep all day. Yeah, I hear you. I'm there. Good. Jackie. Something a man might do all day long if his partner let him?
Go to the races.
Go to the races. He could be doing that. Second strike. Garcarczyk's could steal. We need the points here, Craig.
Go to the cricket.
He might go to the cricket. That's three strikes, I'm afraid. Garcarczyk's. Baden.
Watch movies.
Jade.
Hang out with mates.
Jasmine.
Maybe eat. Eat all day?
Could eat all day. Frederico, you are the boss. Wonderful options. Triple point round. You're close to the 300 mark. That's where you become champions. And not only that, you'll go on to your fifth night
on Monday night. Exciting. And play for the car if you can turn 265 to at least 300.
Well, I think Jade's done that with hang around with your mates.
Hang with your mates all day if your partner would let you. Let's see if we can get you guys the win and play for the car on the Monday. Is it on the board? Oh. No, it's not. They're the points the pointer's needed. Seven. Play golf. Relax. Play video games. Watch TV. Well, as you can see, nobody has reached 300 points right now, so it's time to get our team captains up here to the podium for sudden death. Ooh, it's come down to this. There's only one answer on the board here, and it's worth triple points. Whoever wins sudden death right now will win the game and become tonight's champion family. The best of luck, guys. We surveyed 100 people and the top answer is on the board. Name something people straighten. Craig.
Hair.
Is hair the top answer for the win? Well, it is the point of family. Do it! Grabbing a victory in the dying seconds of tonight's game. The Sergeants, Fred.
Thanks,
Jasmine, Jade, and Baden. Wow. You guys have done really well on the show. You'll be taking home $13,250 from your time here on Family Feud. Nice job, mate. Well done. It was great having you on the show. Look at the Sergeants, everybody. But we got some brand new champions. The pointers, come on over. Wow. How's the Iceman at the last minute there? Just bang for the win.
Oh, I'm shaking.
Well, that was pretty cool. There's the smile right there. Right there. What you do, because you're a brand new family, you might not know this just yet, but our soundproof booth is back there and it's waiting for you right now. So you toddle off that
Thank
way. You.
You
and I are going to shoot for 10,000 bucks. We do it next. It's called Fast Money. It's on Family Feud. New champs. Awesome!
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10Play.
Now, welcome back. It's Fast Money time here in the Feud. Let's see if the pointer family can now win some moolah, some casharoonie, some fun tickets.
Or money.
Yeah, or just money. Now, if you and Craig get 200 points or more between you, you'll win $10,000, OK? Now, Craig is currently in our soundproof booth and can't hear your answers. Oh, he's just... Yeah. Oh, I'm driving. Wait. Karate chop you. I'm going to ask you 5 questions. Going to give you 20 seconds to answer. Now, if you pass, we'll come back if there's time. And the clock starts at the end of the very first question. So, you set?
Yep.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Best of luck. Other than leaves, name something you associate with trees.
Bark.
Name something you cut into pieces before eating.
Steak.
Name someone a man relies on for advice.
Wife.
Name something people chew on when they're nervous.
Nails.
Name a situation when you'd need a towel.
After getting out of the shower.
Shower. Of course you would. Yep. You were just so controlled and you were like a little mouse just shooting the answers out confidently. Was it like that inside?
A little bit.
Yeah.
I had a little bit of nerves.
Nice. Other than leaves, name something you associate with trees. You said bark. Survey says... Good start. Name something you cut into pieces before eating. You said steak you do. Survey says... 12. Name someone a man relies on for advice. You said. His wife, if he knows what's good for him. Survey says. 24. Really playing well. Name something people chew on when they're nervous. You said. Chew on your nails. Survey says. Fantastic. To be at the halfway mark with one to go is brilliant. Name a situation when you'd need a towel. You said. It's pretty obvious, Grant, when you're getting out the shower. Survey says... Oh, man! Holy, head back to family. Nice one. Beautiful. Yeah.
Thank you, mate.
You're going to love Hayley. You okay. only need a total of 51 points to get $10,000.
Oh, my God.
So, yeah, exactly.
Could be hard, too.
Oh, you did a great job. All right, I'm going to give you the same five questions, but you're the second player and it's a little harder, so I'll give you an extra 5 seconds, yep. okay? Now, if you pass on a question, I'll ask it again if there's time.
Yep.
And if you repeat an answer that's already there, you'll hear this sound. And I'll ask you to try again.
Yep.
Can we remind everybody of Hayley's answers? And 25 seconds on the clock too, please. The time starts from the end of the very first question. Good luck, Craig.
Thank you.
Other than leaves, name something you associate with trees.
Branches.
Name something you cut into pieces before eating.
Cheese.
Name someone a man relies on for advice.
Handyman.
Name something people chew on when they're nervous.
Chewing gum.
Name a situation when you'd need a towel.
After a shower.
Try again.
After a bath.
Nice. That was actually pretty good. Ready? Let's go. How do you think you went?
All right, I hope. I'm hoping.
Was it like you thought it would be?
Yeah, it was a bit hard, but I don't know. I really don't know. You've got to see what 100 other people think.
Let's do that. Other than leaves, name something you associate with trees. You said branches. Pretty happy with that answer?
I am happy with that answer.
Survey says... nice. With good reason to be happy about it, because it was the top answer. Name something you cut into pieces before eating. You said... cheese. That one?
I don't know.
Survey says... four.
Oh, four. Seven.
Top answer was apple. So we need 23 now for $10,000. Name someone a man relies on for advice. You said... handyman. Survey says... Hayley had the top answer of wife.
Hold on, mate.
We need 23 from the last two answers for $10,000. Are you thinking about the money a little bit?
I'm thinking about my answers. I've forgotten them.
Let me help you out. Name something people chew on when they're nervous. You said... chewing gum. It's not a bad answer.
Mm.
What would you spend the money on if you won it?
Well, we're going to do a holiday. We said we'd do that, so a family holiday, because I might have the kids, or the oldest might move on to uni, so...
So while they're all together, yeah.
While we're all together, might be a last hurrah, so...
That's pretty important.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Nice opportunity to really cement yourselves as a family for one last time.
Yep. And we're taking Mum, of course, so, yeah. She's got to come. We're a team. We've got to go as a team, so, yeah.
Survey says... It's news for all the family. Join us again on Monday when we all come back to play a little more Family Feud together. It feels nice when we do that. I'm Grant Denyer. Good night, Australia.